This is the co-main event of the evening, where Gangsta Rap presents this Supreme Championship hybrid boxing title over 5 2-minute rounds in the light heavyweight division. So let's get the action started by once again welcoming into the red corner. He comes with a record of 22 wins, 5 losses, 2 draws. He's the former English champion from the Soxies Boxing Stable in Southampton. Please give a warm welcome to Richard Soxie Martin. And facing him this evening in the blue corner, he comes with a record of 50 wins, 25 losses, 4 draws. He's the multiple boxing champion from the MK1 gym in Bournemouth. Please welcome Mo Kogbo, your referee in charge of the action, Mr. Clive Allison.
It's time for the co-main event of the evening. It's Richard Soxie versus Mo Kogbo. 41 years old versus 53 years old. But I tell you what, many a youth would hit the canvas hard if they dared step in front of these guys. I'm Danny Kendrick, and joining me in the commentary box of this one is my buddy and top fighter and trainer Andy Turland. How are we feeling today?
Yes, good. Thank you. Very excited for this one, Danny.
I suppose you know these guys well from these parts of the woods.
I've been punched by Mo. It hurts.
I've seen both these guys. I've presented both of these guys to the ring and commentated on both of them on more than one occasion. This is set up, and let me tell you something. Pumped. Anyone watching back home, these 4-ounce gloves take no prisoners.
They are dangerous things. Dangerous things.
Just setting up now. Soxie's just letting that left hand go. He wants to parry the hand of Kogbo, but he's very hard to hit, right?
He's very hard to hit. Look at the head movement already. Round one. Both look pumped for this fight.
Martin's always in good shape, well, Soxie, isn't he? Yeah. Both of them. For that age, I tell you what, in your mid-20s, you'd want to look
they
like that,
move.
Right?
Yeah, they can move.
And let me tell you, there's no games played in these 4-ounce gloves.
If anyone's
been punched in the face with those by a mixed martial artist or anyone, let me tell you, these guys are solid boxers as well.
Yeah. Very experienced, guys. Very experienced.
Your defence needs to be on point, right?
Yes, very tight guard with these gloves. Oh, most head movement, though, is second to none, isn't it? Look at that. Oh.
He's so hard to hit, isn't he?
Definitely. Oh, he's doing well. Soxie's catching him.
Soxie's got very, very fast hands. Kogbo just likes to grow in fights. Look,
does.
He works his way forward.
Slow.
It's that style, isn't it?
Slippy.
You sparred with him yourself, Andy?
I have, yes. I'll tell you what, when I was a few years ago when he bust my face up a few times. Yeah, he has. He's a big guy. I was only small back then. Oh, look at that. Lovely.
Oh, good shot. Off balanced him with a shot to the body.
Back with the head movement, though.
His own feet sometimes.
Back with the head movement, though.
Good
end of round one.
For Martin now. I tell you, that's a good round for him. Very hard to hit, but he did catch him quite a few times. But I'll tell you what, his left eye is bleeding here.
Bleeding everywhere now. He's going to be opened up now. He's opened up. Tank.
There's going to be 5 2-minute rounds, so we're now going into the second of that. Live here.
Here we go.
Supreme Cage Fighting Championship.
Looking forward to this one.
Round two.
Touch gloves. Nice is exchanged. But now they're looking. Yeah, that eye is cut, isn't it?
It's cut, right? It's open.
They've Vaseline that up.
They've done a good job.
They have.
He needs to get to work on that eye.
Mo's looking at it. I can see him focused on it now.
Here he goes.
Look,
there he's trying to open
away.
It up.
That right hand is looking for that eye all the time. Watch.
Here it is. There it is. Oh.
Richard Soxie ducks out the way.
Lovely head
back.
Movement from both parties there. Oh, good body shot there by Soxie.
Yeah, Soxie's going down to the body at the moment. He's going to come over the top at some point.
He's setting it up, isn't he? Setting it up.
Do you think Kogbo's wise to that, though?
I don't know. I think he probably is. He's had enough bouts in there, so yeah. I think he probably
is.
He
starts to do the same. It's going to be more stylistic, you'd expect from Kogbo, wouldn't you?
Yes.
More of a warrior fight from Soxie.
Soxie, brawler, get in there. Bit like myself, Danny. But yeah, his eye is opened up there now.
I think it's how you do it down here on the south coast, right?
Yeah, then we're looking weird. That's what we're made for. He wants to go to work on that eye now.
He does. I'll tell you what.
But he doesn't want to get caught.
His eye flickered a couple of times then. He needs to watch the referee.
Oh, look, he's cut open now.
He is. That is the professionalism.
Look at that. That's the precision.
Yep.
Look at it there. He can't even see now.
No. Carbo,
it's not going to see the rounds.
Very clever. Yeah. Very clever. He's wise, isn't he?
There's that experience there, isn't it? 55, 75 fights. He's not aiming anywhere else.
Every shot's at the eye.
And he's already touching his face now, wiping it out there, isn't he?
Yep.
There you go
so
again, same
hard
thing.
So your vision's gone. Us Muay Thai fighters know it.
We certainly do.
The times we're trying to get, use the Velcro, the glove to try and get it off your
face.
It's
not like water, is it? It's like a thick grease in your eyes.
Oh, look, he's in trouble now.
He's in trouble. It won't see the end of this round.
No, referee Clive Allison's having a very good look at that as well.
Yeah. Mo's just taking it easy.
He will stop it.
He keeps touching it as well. Oh, there you go. In Muay Thai, that would be a big score.
Yeah. Well, he goes in at the end of this round.
Lovely. Great round by them, both boys.
Goes in at the end of this round, Mo. Knowing what he's got to do, he looked fired up at the end of that round.
He did a great job there. Knew exactly what he was doing and followed it through well.
Myself, Lovely. Danny Kendrick. I'm in the commentary box with Andy Aterlan, a now multiple champion on the K1 kickboxing scene here in the UK. And Soxie Martin is now
I can see this
from the
going
ground,
again.
Really.
Straight for that right-hand side of the eye.
Do you think he'll change it up and use that feint to go somewhere else?
Or do you think he'll constantly tag that? I don't know. You know,
Moby.
Oh, there we go. Ready to stop. Yes, a count.
Got to
be a count.
53 years young and he's still
knocking people
out. People that put in front of him.
Those four-ounce gloves are different breed. Different breed.
There's no games played in these four-ounce gloves.
I was sparring with him with some MMA boys last week and I got hit on the ear. And I tell you what, it isn't nice. It's not nice.
Soxie's now emergency mode.
Yeah.
He needs to find something. He needs to throw some gunslingers.
Oh, here we go.
He's got to hurt Mo Carbo. If he doesn't hurt him here, he's going to get done. He's going to get wised out.
There
look, it's just the precision of Mo.
And that head movement too.
You can't hit him. And look, it's the precision. He's not even hitting
straight
it that hard.
Eye,
look.
Yeah. Just accurate.
It's the professionalism, isn't it?
Yeah, so much. It's just that experience, isn't it? It's just that experience. Oh, there we go again. Nice by Soxie, nice right hand.
This is
lovely.
A
this is better.
For every single one of you back home, respect your elders.
100%.
They know stuff that you don't know. Carbo is showing you.
Oh, once here we go, there we go. Precision again. He can't see that
button.
Now. He doesn't want to hit him, he doesn't want to carry on. Again, it's just that precision again. Experience, precision, timing. Look, he doesn't want it to go on. It's dangerous, isn't it? But come
he's
on,
he's gone to his corner, throw the towel in. They're not going to throw the towel in.
Yeah, Soxie.
He doesn't want to damage him anymore.
And if there's one guy, like you said, that can do it, it is Soxie.
This fight's going one way now.
There you go.
I think Clive Ellison will stop this bout.
Yeah, I think so too. One more shot to that face, I think
Soxie's
it's over.
Soxie's got heart. Soxie's got courage.
There we go,
Soxie's
nice.
Soxie's got determination.
Oh, he's seen the round.
And the big punch when
he needs
it.
The round. He saw the round. Wow, my goodness me, congratulations.
He threw a couple of very good shots
at
the end there.
Caught him there. Maybe Mo's getting complacent, I don't know. But that was a great fight, great round.
You never know what's going to happen in a fight. You could have all the game plans in the world, but you need a game
until
B,
you get hit in
a
that
game
face.
C, a game D, and a game E.
1 million percent, and
over.
They stopped it. Great fight by both fighters.
I think the paramedic came in
paramedic,
and stopped
it. Paramedic, yeah, absolutely. He wouldn't have stopped otherwise. No way. Absolutely.
Ladies and gentlemen, huge respect for both these fantastic boxers. Come on, a round of applause. Our referee calls a stop to this contest at the end of round number three. So let's hear it for your winner and new Supreme Championship Hybrid Boxing Champion in the blue corner, Mo Carbo. And your runner-up, Richard Soxie Martin.
I've got one thing to say to all three tiers of this O2 Arena. The lesson that everyone must learn tonight is respect your elders. Because I tell you what, they know stuff we don't know, because once you got that cut, the accuracy of your shots was phenomenal.
Yeah, I saw the blood. That's all I need. I saw blood. I thought, ooh, I'm going to go for that.
It's like a shark. He smelt the blood and he went in.
Well, these gloves, my last opponent, I broke his nose. His face was a mess. So I knew I was going to do damage to this one as well. But the shot was just, it wasn't supposed to be a hard shot, just a snappy shot, and it went bang. With these gloves, they're dangerous.
There's no games played in these 4-ounce gloves, right? If any of you have not been hitting 4-ounce gloves, trust me, it is a different game, right?
Yeah, I don't know. I've never felt it, but...
This guy's one of the hardest guys to hit I've ever commentated on. I've done loads of his fights. How many fights have you had now? I don't think you even know yourself, do you?
Over 150 at least.
Wow. Guys, that needs a round of applause just for a start.
That's kickboxing, that's everything. That's all. That's what I do.
And is there an age limit to this?
I'm 53.
I know that. Is there a limit, though?
I'm going to be 54 in May.
And does it stop there?
I'll be in a wheelchair doing this.
The Wheelchair Olympics. This guy's going to be champion if he's there. I don't think you're ever going in one of them, my friend.
I love the sport too much. I love fighting. I love training. I love training and fighting and training. I love training my fighters. I love... To my coach, I want to say a big thank you to my coach for coming down from Portsmouth, Ty Brown. We worked on so much today. He basically just told me what to do. Just with this 4-ounce glove, it's easy. I can tell my student Musa, you know, my kids.
Kids, how did Dad do today?
Really good. Amazing.
That makes it worth it, right?
I also want to thank Natalie and Jordan for giving me a chance to do it again in 4-ounce gloves, because they know how much I love to fight. And they always give me a chance to fight. Every time I say I want to fight, they say, we'll get you somebody. So I want to thank everyone for coming down, for supporting me. Even if you hate me, thank you for coming down and watching me try and lose. Thank you. I love you all. Thank you all very much.
One more time, it's Mo Cogbo!